If you're a Jehovah's Witness, probably you're terrified of having anything to do with apostates. Why? Because apostates are supposed to be mentally diseased.
The organization warns us that they feast at the table of demons, and that they seek to draw off followers after themselves with their gangrenous words.
But what exactly are apostates? Well, that really depends on which of the three definitions you accept.
According to the Bible, an apostate is someone who abandons true worship of the God of the Scriptures.
Then you have Watchtower's definition.
According to a 1980 Watchtower letter to district and circuit overseers, an apostate is anyone who so much as thinks differently from the faithful slave class.
And according to the dictionary, an apostate is simply somebody who walks away from their former religion.
To a Jehovah's Witness, walking away from Watchtower and the governing body is considered unforgivable, a crime worthy of punishment through shunning.
But most people believe that the ability to leave one's religion without reprisals is a basic human right,
enshrined in Article 18 of the Universal Declaration.
It's also worth remembering that many Jehovah's Witnesses are baptized when they're still just children, and they scarcely know anything about the organization or its history.
Ask yourself honestly, when you were baptized, did you know that the Watchtower publications taught for over four decades that the Pyramid of Giza was built by Jehovah with the dimensions corresponding to Bible chronology?
Or that Rutherford believed that Jehovah lived in the Pleiades star cluster.
Or that Rutherford expected the resurrected Moses, David, and Samson to come live with him in San Diego.
An apostate is not some boogeyman.
No. An apostate is simply someone who has done their own objective research.
And after reviewing all the available information, including in Watchtower's own publications, he's come to the conclusion that Jehovah's Witnesses aren't God's one true religion after all.
But what is it that apostates really want?
What is their agenda?
And why, after they've left the organization, do they feel they need to write negative and say negative things about the belief system that they left behind?
These are important questions, and the purpose of this video is to dispel a few myths.
Myth number one. Apostates hate Jehovah's Witnesses and wish to persecute them.
Actually, most apostates differentiate between Jehovah's Witnesses and the organization that leads them.
Jehovah's Witnesses are viewed by them not as enemies who must be crushed, but as victims of manipulation and indoctrination through misinformation.
Far from hating Jehovah's Witnesses, apostates care deeply for them and want only the best for them.
After all, many apostates have family members that are still witnesses.
Myth number two.
Apostates seek to draw followers after themselves.
Yes, it's true. Some of the more eccentric former witnesses can sometimes be a little too evangelical about their newfound religious beliefs.
But for the most part, apostates aren't especially interested in converting Jehovah's Witnesses from one faith to another.
What most apostates are truly concerned about is the number of people being lied to by Watchtower, including children, and the harm these teachings can cause.
And that brings us to myth number three. Apostates lie and exaggerate about the organization.
Far from exaggerating about the organization, most of the information found on apostate websites is really just scratching the surface.
Why? Because so much about the Watchtower is kept secret and is difficult to quantify.
We really have no way of knowing, for example, how much money Watchtower makes, or how many alleged pedophiles are on Watchtower's records,
or how many people die for refusing a blood transfusion each year.
What we do know is that in several areas, Watchtower teachings and practices are hurting and even killing people.
Take for example shunning. If you end up being shunned by your witness family through disfellowshipping, a practice described in a 1947 Awake article as altogether foreign to Bible teaching, you can end up emotionally traumatized.
We humans just aren't programmed to cope with loneliness and ostracism, especially for unjust reasons. The mental stress can be so great that some disfellowshipped ones have even committed suicide. Again, we don't know how many, but the stories are out there.
Then there's the mishandling of child abuse, as reported on extensively by the media.
There is a crisis of silence within the Jehovah's Witness organization. A crisis of cover-up of the abuse, the sexual abuse of children, that has been going on for decades.
A new report sheds light on a widespread practice among Jehovah's Witnesses of using one of America's most sacred rights to shield itself from child sexual abuse claims.
For almost 20 years, they've ordered them to send reports like this one for every known child abuser, to hide these cases from their congregations, and not to cooperate with law enforcement or the courts unless instructed to.
I don't know of any other religious organization, which is how this is framed,
yes,
which has the processes with the flaws that we've identified in the Jehovah's Witnesses.
If ever there was a group that needs the sun to shine on them, it's this one. Because when your doorbell rings on Saturday morning and your kid answers the door, you don't want that guy to be a child molester.
If you are molested as a child by one of your fellow Jehovah's Witnesses, there's a good chance that nothing will happen to your abuser, and that he will go on to abuse other children.
Why? Because elders are instructed that unless there is a second witness to the abuse, they must leave the matter in Jehovah's hands.
Apostates don't want the organization to have a problem with child abuse. We would much rather children were safe and protected, but pretending that there isn't a problem isn't going to fix things.
Then we have the prohibition on higher education.
If you are a young person in the organization, your future prospects will be seriously impeded by Watchtower's reckless and selfish stance against college and university.
Many witnesses devote years or even decades to pioneering for the organization, assuming Armageddon is imminent, only to end up with virtually no money or skills to care for themselves or their families in later years.
Domestic violence is also a huge problem. If you're married to a Jehovah's Witness who later starts being abusive to you, you're essentially stuck with him or her for life.
Unless one of you admits to adultery, your only option is separation.
And last but not least, blood transfusions.
If you refuse a blood transfusion for a flawed interpretation of the Bible command to abstain from eating blood, you could end up losing your life.
For many witness children that face this scenario, many of them don't even have a choice. And their parents don't even regret withholding life-saving treatment until it's too late.
Of course, it could be that you see no problem with any of these issues. If that's the case, feel free to ignore this video and spend the rest of your life supporting and promoting JW.org and its ever-changing doctrines.
If you value intellectual honesty and you don't like being lied to or seeing people get hurt, then we urge you to shake off your Watchtower-induced fear of apostate books and websites and start doing some digging.
Some of the most important online resources include jwfacts.com,
AAWA.co.
Taze.co.
GWPodcast.org.
JehovahsWitnessBlog.com.
GWStruggle.com.
WatchtowerDocuments.com.
And JWSurvey.org.
JW Survey in particular has a global survey that you are invited to partake in.
It gives you the chance to say what you really think about the Watchtower policies in total confidentiality.
Last year, over 5,000 participated in this survey.
And the results showed that hundreds of active witnesses, including elders, are concerned about some of the organization's more harmful elements.
Listen, we ex-JWs do understand, and we can remember what it feels like when you first take the plunge and start doing research, especially those first few clicks. It's absolutely terrifying, but we can assure you it is worth it.
After all, if Watchtower really has the truth, shouldn't that truth be able to stand up to even the heaviest possible scrutiny or criticism?
Ultimately, you need to ask yourself, is this true or isn't it? If it is true, there should be some evidence.
If there is no evidence, then Jehovah's Witnesses are no more credible or worthy of your time than any other religion.
And life is too short to waste years or even decades devoting yourself to something that isn't true.
Apostates are not your enemies.
We are happy, contented people who have found freedom from fear and control, and we just want to share it.
We love humanity. We believe in respect and equality.
And want what's best for everyone, including Jehovah's Witnesses.
We have a variety of beliefs and backgrounds, and we come from all over the world.
I'm from San Antonio, Texas.
I'm from Romania.
I'm from Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
I live in Bathurst, Australia.
I live in New Hampshire, USA.
I'm from Johannesburg, South Africa.
I'm from South Wales.
Vancouver Island, Canada.
My name is Esther, and I'm from Germany.
I'm from Byron, California.
Hi, I'm from Estonia. I live in Tallinn.
I live in Houston, Texas.
I live in Estonia.
I'm from Atlanta.
I'm from the Netherlands. I live in Medellin, Colombia.
I'm Julie from Miami, via Benito Amiami.
I'm from Germany.
I am from Galesville, Connecticut.
Hi, I'm from the historical city of Ghent in Belgium.
I'm from Urbana, Illinois.
I live in Rio de Janeiro.
I'm from Wolfboro, New Hampshire.
I live in Ravensburg, Germany.
I'm Shane, living in Galway, Ireland.
I'm from Bern, Switzerland.
My name is Susan Gaskin, and I'm from Montreal, Canada.
We're all here to tell you, you don't have to be afraid anymore.
It is time to wake up.
Look behind the curtain and start exploring the wealth of information that's freely available.
You owe it to yourself to know what's really going on and to live in the here and now.
Rather than the doomsday fantasy of a bunch of guys in New York.
Open your eyes and see how deep the rabbit hole really goes.
Be honest and true to yourself. And learn what real freedom is all about.
We are proud apostates, and we're here to help. See you around.
To complain about.